Hey everybody, it's Clint Arthur, and I'm making this quick video. Actually, this ain't no quick video. This is a celebrity entrepreneur adventure number 301. Yeah! Hey, this is a very exciting celebrity entrepreneur adventure. I'm here in Acapulco. This is my first celebrity entrepreneur adventure in Acapulco. I wanted to give you a little bit of insight into my actual life here, driving down into town to get my final eye checkup with my ophthalmologist after my intraocular lens surgery. If you haven't seen that video, you know, if you haven't seen those, go through my profile and look on my Facebook profile for the eye surgery updates, because I just had my eyes scooped out and my lenses replaced with trifocal intraocular lenses. Now I don't need reading glasses. Now I just can see near, medium, and far, no problemo. So I'm going to get my final checkup. It was 30 days ago, and I'm just using my beautiful, expensive sunglasses instead of my cheap Amazon bifocal sunglasses that I used to use. I'm going in for that, and I'm also going to get some stuff for one of our events. We're doing a whole bunch of events coming up here, including Ali's Share Your Gifts event and my Impact, Influence, and Income Mastery in Paradise event. And then Celebrity Launchpad number 53 will be happening here in the third week of October. And then the last week of October is a titanium only mastermind for my titanium coaching clients who will be staying for a private small group publicity and business building mastermind with me and the other titaniums for a week. So that's going to be super fun. But after my eye doctor appointment, I'm going to go into the little marketplace across the street from the ophthalmologist. There's this local crafts market. You know, I wouldn't say there's a lot of like crafts that they're making there, but I'm gonna go buy some bags that say Acapulco, because these are gift bags for Ali's attendees who are coming to share their gifts. They start out by receiving a gift from Ali, which will be in one of these beautiful Acapulco bags. So there you go. Now there's a little traffic right here when we get to this intersection, because they're digging up the streets right in front of Walmart. But after this, it'll just open right up again. Bunch of condo buildings here. Acapulco, baby. Main road goes all along the beach. BMW Acapulco. And here's the place. This is called the Diana. This is one of my favorite sculptures. Statues. This is the Diana Circle. And in that shopping center over there is my ophthalmologist's office, where I'm going. And then this is the crafts market over here. I need to find a little parking spot. this one. I'll take it. Exactly right in front of where I'm going. It's always hard to park here because it's on a curve. But I often get this nice parking spot. One day I'm gonna go here to Casa Nostra and get a pizza. One day. This Diana Circle, it's like a famous landmark here in Acapulco. And I'm only a few minutes late for my appointment, so that's pretty good for Mexico. I've also thought about going to this place, Pizzeria Napoli, but they're always closed whenever I'm here. Here's the ophthalmology office of Dr. Ariel Ramirez. ¿Cómo está? That's him. They used to give me a hard time when I would come in without a mask. They always have Natural Geographic stuff in Spanish playing on here. Oftentimes it's like animals getting killed and stuff, but this is baby elephants, I like that. I have a bad feeling about this.
Dominan el abrevadero, pero a medida que cae la noche, el poder cambia de manos.
I have a very bad feeling about this. So, like I was saying, they used to give me a hard time about not having a mask, but now that I've paid them a few thousand dollars to have new eyes, no problemo.
What did you see there?
Perfecto. Mm-hmm. Do we get a score? I want a score. I want to know what my my prescription really is.
Mm-hmm. Take a few seconds because the machine is charging.
Okay.
Okay, now he's ready. Put your forehead in the plastic, please. Okay, perfect. Okay. Now the score, the right one is 0.0. The left one is 0.5. Very good. Very good.
I'm very happy.
Yes.
They don't hurt. I don't feel them anymore.
The lights, the red lights, they have a problem with the red light the first month.
You know, at nighttime, I don't really have a problem, really, with glare, with halos.
No, only with...
red lights, huh?
Red light. When it's raining in the glare, maybe it's when the car in front of me put the stop lights.
Yep.
And then a little brighter, a little yellow, but not always. That's all that I have.
I'm very happy.
Yeah, me too. For me, I'm very happy because I don't want to wear glasses and I can read, I can open my eyes, I can take my phone. Or read the news.
I know. It's great.
It's correct.
It really is liberty.
Liberty.
It's liberty.
Liberty. Yes.
It really
liberty.
Is. That's the name of the lens, and it really is freedom.
Yeah. Freedom.
To see.
To see.
Mm-hmm.
And it's for real life. For the at least for the next 50 years.
50 years.
At least.
You can't get cataracts with this because the cataract can't grow on the artificial lens. Is that right?
Yes.
That's correct.
Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not a cataract. It's when you put a lens, you have a support. And that works the first 2 months. After 2 months, the lens has a little legs and it's attached with his legs.
Yeah.
But that little membrane that is that helps to support the lens, in the first 5 years, you have the 50% that this little membrane will be a little fuzzy. And with Jack Lasser, we remove it. It's not this to retina, it's 50%. If it don't happen in the first 5 years, that never happens.
Okay. Wonderful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Okay. That's all, folks.
That's all, folks. Okay. Well, okay. Dr. Ariel, thank you so much. Great so job. Much. Really great job. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
I'm happy. When you see the patient is happy, my heart is...
I'm very happy.
Very happy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're
I'll
welcome.
I'll see you.
See you.
Ciao.
Ciao.
See what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying. Here we are. I'll just show you around. It's like, there's this little beach club back here. I've never been to it, but I'm gonna take you here to see. I've never like gone to this club, but it looks pretty nice. Just to give you an idea of where we are, right? Look at this. I don't have to go to this beach club, but you know, Mexican tourists like to go to this beach club. It's pretty nice. Another nice restaurant up there. There's two clubs here, actually. El Moro Restaurant and Bar. Permiso? See this? How cool is that? Pretty sweet. And then that one looks very nice too. This one is more family oriented. You'll see. Look at this. You know, basically the situation is, it's a restaurant. You come here, you enjoy the restaurant, and you have the benefit of the beach and the ocean. It's pretty amazing. You see the cross up there? Our house is up there on the hill. Our house is just below the cross, and then we have another house on the other side of where all those houses are. All right, time to go buy some bags for Allie. I'm gonna try and get some money too. I think I need more money. Best way to get money in Acapulco or in Mexico is out of a cash machine, ATM. You know, you can bring cash and get your cash exchange, but honestly, you're better off getting money out of ATMs. And the best ATMs are Citibanamex, where there's no fee, but it's amazing. They charge you like 30 pesos, which is $1.50 for the transaction. And then they give you the best rate. Unfortunately, I don't think I'm near a Citibanamex. Out, I am near a Banamex, so I'm gonna go give you a report. Here I am hanging out in the shade while I'm waiting across the street. Being in the shade is very important in Mexico, otherwise you're gonna get a lot of sun during the day. Now I am inside the marketplace trying to get what I need, these bags here. So these little Acapulco bags. Just trying to sell the dresses, but I came here for the bags. The first lady was so stupid. She's like, oh, I can't do 150 pesos. Like, it has to be 160 pesos. It's like so stupid. And I bought so many from her last time. This lady's no problem for 150 pesos. See, all different ones, very nice. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, see, nine, 10. Esta, yep, 11. Uno más. Naranja. 12. Perfecto, inteligente. Okay, so when you're selling stuff and you have a returning customer, I mean, I just walked right into the first store, right, where I've been before. See? I just walked right into the first store where I've been before. I'll take you through so you can see, you know, kind of what's here. This is part of, you know, the women like to go shopping. We like to take them to this marketplace because it's safe and there's a lot of vendors here. A lot of the stuff is the same, but, you know, there's some stuff. Thank you. See, 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 see.
that's fine.
So, you know, I walked into that first stall.
Hola.
Hola. And here's another jewelry market. And the lady haggled with me. I said, I need 12 bags for 150 pesos each. She's like, oh no, it has to be 160 pesos. And I'm like, you know, what a dummy. When I'm nice enough, they remembered me. Last time we were there, we bought mugs. We bought like all these bags. We bought all these mugs. She remembered me. She knows that I'm an easy spender with cash. And she doesn't just give me what I want. It's just so stupid. Just so stupid. So now I have to go back and rub it in her face, right? I have to show her. See? Gracias. Gracias.
I got a big backpack.
That's okay. Thank you.
I got mine. It's good to show you.
So there you go. And here's my parking spot. And there's the Diana. I think it's gonna wrap up this celebrity entrepreneur adventure. Adios, amigos. Well, one of the vendors came out and like insisted that I come and look at his shop, and I bought a little angel there for $10. Addendum. Addendum. I really want to buy like an ATV. They have these cool ATVs that I recently discovered called Polaris. There's also a Yamaha XYZ 1000. It's a four-wheel side-by-side. It's not where you're sitting with the driver in the front and the passenger behind them. It's two seats, one next to each other, inside of like a very sporty, almost a dune buggy. I wish there was some place to buy one around here. I haven't found any place yet that sells them. But that's what I'm looking for. I may go to Mexico City to get one. Presidente, in honor of Dave Portnoy. Extra addendum. I freaking love this kind of music. This is called banda.
Mm.
everybody just starts going, even though the light is red. I don't know why they line up like that at these banks. They must be getting free money or something. Extra addendum, you know, first of all, it's a beautiful song. I've decided to go in search of one of those ATVs on the other side of the mountain. We live on the top of the mountain, like I showed you. On the other side of the mountain, is a store that sells motorcycles. And I decided to make this addendum because I'm going through this tunnel, and it's a very cool tunnel. Here you go. It's costing me 60 pesos to go through this tunnel, which is like $3. I'm gonna lose my beautiful song, I think, but you know, it's a beautiful tunnel. This is a beautiful tunnel. I mean, in the US, we don't have nice tunnels like this. They're all like, even when they fix them up, look how big it is. Love this tunnel. Instead of taking like 10 to 15 minutes to go over the mountain, I just went through the mountain in 3 minutes. I definitely, you know, the gas alone that I saved paid for me to go through the tunnel, right?
Por favor, premium. ¿Sí?
Completo American Express.
Ok, llegamos, okay. Compramos entonces. ¿Cómo quieras? ¿Algún servicio? ¿Que tomas algo?
No.
Todo bien.
Ok, gracias. ¿Cómo
quieras? See, they pump your gas for you. So how much is it? It's like... ¿Cómo quieras? It's 23.45 pesos. Which is about $1.20 per liter, and there's 4 liters. So it's about $5 a gallon for premium. Pumped for you by a nice lady who's happy to do it. That's her tip, and she'll be very happy to get that.